People, que pasa, sa pase, what they do. Now this first video is going to make you scratch your head when you hear all the details. And this is about some three rogue cops, and we are speaking about some young buck. Some police officers that range between the age of 24 and 27. And we are speaking about Corporal Adrian Jackson. We are talking about Corporal LaShane Bryan. And we are also speaking about Corporal Ramon Wellington. Now this incident happened in Westmoreland. We are talking about Hanover. And it is said that according to the information and report, it is said that these three officers were on patrol when they flagged down a minibus. And when them searched the bus, they searched a 16-year-old. We are speaking about a teenager. And it is alleged that the teenager had a gun in his bag. So anyway, it is said that these officers told the teenager to get in the police car, and that he's going to be charged for illegal possession of a burner. Now, when them take this little teenager off of the bus, instead of taking him to the police station and charging him likewise, they decided that they had another plan. They decided that they were going to come up with a grand scheme to get some money to extort him. So what they did, they said to the teenager, listen, you are facing some serious charges, but you can't help yourself if you call your family member, call your mother to be more specific. So anyway, this young man called his mother, and the mother said, they asked her that they needed 2 million Jamaican dollars, so we are speaking about in excess of maybe 15 to 16 thousand US dollars, or else he was going to face the brunt of the law. So anyway, the mother kind of agreed. The mother kind of psyched them out, because she said, wait, hold on a minute, first thing first, what is my son doing with a burner? What is my son, who is 16 year old, doing with a heat, doing with a strap? And even worse, why is the popo calling my number and telling me to pay $2 million so they can free my son? Something definitely wrong. There is something fundamentally wrong with this situation, point blank and period. So anyways, the mother of this teenager decided that she was going to comply and meet these officers with the ransom money. We are speaking about the $2 million, but she had another plan. So what she did, she went to the police officer, she went to the police station, and next police station, and she reported the matter to the police. So then the police them set up a sting, and them say, all right, we're going to meet these officers, these three rogue cops in Westmoreland, and we are going to act as if we are going to pay them the money, and then we are basically going to bust them in a sting. So anyways, the mother and the three rogue cops decided that they are going to meet up at a specified location. So the mother is bringing the popo with her. We are speaking about what's supposed to be the legitimate police, and she is going to meet the rogue cops. So now people remember now that this is a very serious situation, and the mother of this child had to be cautious, because they threatened her son that if he could not help himself, they were going to slap him away. So with sister, they are facing something that they have to be very careful and strategic with whatever they do. So anyways, it seems like when the mother went with the undercover to meet these rogue cops, it seems like the rogue cops them basically smell a rat. They realized that something was wrong. So now after these three bad popo smell the rats, them come up with a plan of their own. Them claim, so them fling with the heat, them fling with the burner that they allegedly caught this little boy with. And what they did, they took the little boy to the station and they arrested him for illegal possession of a dangerous weapon, which was a knife or two knife and a scissors. So now people, we see so the things change. We see so their report is now changed. So now remember, you know, they claim or they allege that they found this little teenager with a heat or a burner in his bag, and they were going to slap him away or even worse, take him to the police station. So now when we hear all these twists and turns and ups and downs and ebbs and flow, and the amount of Anansi's story and Brother Tukuman's story, we have to wonder if this youth actually had a burner on him, or was this a plan or a scheme by these three thieving, scamming, bad rogue cops to get some money, to get $2 million, because they are basically hungry belly. So anyways, the moral of the story is that these three rogue cops, they got busted and they were charged. They were convicted in court, and people, what is even more shocking is the sentence that they got. Now, these three rogue cops each receive 3 years suspended sentence. So that means that they are not going to see a day in prison. They are not going to see a day behind bars, which is what they truly deserve. And they were also fined $250,000. People, we are speaking about little over $2,000. Now, people, when we think about what they did, and we think about the sentence, and we think about the fine, we see that it does not coexist. It is not equal to, it does not equate to the seriousness of their crimes. So we have to wonder if something is fundamentally wrong with the justice system. Because obviously we see that in Jamaica, the poor cannot get any justice. But we also see when it pertains to politicians, police and rich people, there is a difference in the law. There is a difference in the sentence for these three people. Because like me said, people, this was a serious crime, because we don't know if this youth actually had a gun, and we don't know what was the intention of these three rogue cops, if they were actually going to slap away this little boy, if they were actually trying to pin a GUN on an innocent teenager just for their own selfish agenda. So when they realized that the odds were against them, and that the evidence was stacking up against them, and that they were basically caught with their hands in the cookie jar, point blank and period, they decided to plead guilty for a lesser charge. So in this plea agreement, they were charged with perverting the course of justice, and they paid $250,000 in fine, and they were given a 3-year suspended sentence each. Now, what made this plea agreement even more mind-boggling is that the prosecution decided to drop the more serious charges. We are speaking about extortion, and we are also speaking about kidnapping, because you know that those charges bring more time. So the moral of the story and the point that I am trying to make is that the prosecution decided that they are going to charge him with the least serious charge. So now, people, like me say, we see once again where the punishment does not fit the crime. So people, we see once again where the police are charged with some serious charge, and they basically get a slap on the wrist. Now, when the news broke about the minimum sentence that these officers got, the prosecution got a backlash from people in law enforcement and social media, because people are saying that the crime did not match the punishment, and people, it is quite obvious that certain people in society, we are speaking about the rich, we are speaking about the politicians, and we are speaking about the popo, they get away with murder all the time. And people, like me say, if the prosecution, if the justice system is not going to set an example or make an example out of these rogue cops, they are going to continue to do the same thing over and over and over. It is going to be a reoccurring theme, point blank and period. So anyway, people, that is my views on that situation. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section.